And it's time now for our political insiders. Tony May and Charlie Giroux live in the studio with us right now.
Thank you guys for joining us, as always, here on CBS 21 News. We want to start out with what we talked about right before the break, the SEC now looking into Harrisburg and the appropriate information they provided to bond investors, trying to figure out, did they provide that appropriate information? And I guess, Tony, we'll start with you.
Well, I think this is a very critical question because of the doubts about municipal bonds across the country. And there's reason to believe that because there hasn't been heavy oversight, that a lot of municipalities may have gone light on fully informing bond buyers and bond holders about the risks they were undertaking, because everybody thought that muni bonds were like gold, you know. Mm-hmm. So this is probably a good thing in the big scheme of things. It's not clear what impact it's going to have on the administration, but it's probably a good thing, really, to put it into a third party to clear the air, because there is so much confusion about the incinerator in Harrisburg.
Charlie, you probably agree with that. Until we know what the investigation determines,
certainly
the
do. And look, I don't think there's any political fallout to the Thompson administration per se, but let's face it, bad economic news for the city of Harrisburg is especially troubling right now. My guess is that the SEC is looking at something that happened long before Mayor Thompson took office. The trust indentures from the incinerator predate her administration by many years, but it really is the city that's at stake here. It's not good news.
The city already under a shadow because of the issues it's had lately with bankruptcy, et cetera. Is this just something else added on top, or can we look at this at maybe?
No, that's what I'm saying. I'm looking at it as a way to clear the air. Mm-hmm. If we can just get one area of city governance or county governance clarified by a third party, they'll say, these are the ground rules. This was good. This was bad. Or it was okay. Then we can move on to other areas. Let's mm-hmm. let's get this incinerator problem clarified and cleared up.
Get it over with.
All right, Charlie. Healthcare reform probably headed to the Supreme Court
yeah.
now.
Judge Roger probably.
Vincent, district judge down in Pensacola, Florida, ruled it unconstitutional today because it forces everyone to buy insurance. Do you think it'll make it all the way to the high court?
I don't take too many bets on what the legal process will do, but I would bet the bottom dollar in my pocket that this goes to the U.S. Supreme Court. I wouldn't have any takers. There's no question that this is headed to the Supreme Court. I think Judge Vincent is right. I think this is unconstitutional. The interesting thing, though, is because there was no quote-unquote severability clause in that multitudinous page document that the Democratic Party put up without having really read it, the whole thing fell because certain provisions were found to be unconstitutional. That's going to be very interesting as we go forward.
How's it going to play out?
Well, this is
in Washington.
The problem that we have with Congress right now is that we're debating about the wrong issues. We're talking about health care as if it were just ordinary interstate commerce. Health care is about people living or dying, and we've got judges deciding it as if we were selling peanuts to Georgia. You know, this should be about health care. It should be about people getting the kind of care they need. And I'm not going to dispute Charlie on what a good lawyer looks for in a bill, but if it's not there, that really is a shame, because innocent people are going to suffer because of it.
Well, innocent people will suffer if the Obamacare plan goes through, Tony. Let's be very clear.
But what does this mean for the people? Because after it winds itself through the legislative process, we're talking maybe 2014?
Exactly.
What does that mean for us now?
That's what I'm saying. If this is ruled unconstitutional by the high court, we've had insurance companies imposing policies, creating policies based upon regulations already promulgated or being promulgated that are going to be invalid. So, you know, will it lead to court cases? Because people will be trying to collect money from individuals who thought they had third-party coverage and they didn't have it. It will be an awful, awful, awful mess.
Senator Mitch McConnell today already put in a provision to repeal Obamacare legislatively. It's the right thing to do at this point. Start over, do it right, find out what we can agree on. There are many provisions on which both sides of the aisle can agree. It does not take this massive
one-size-fits-all, gigantic Obamacare
nonsense that Tony's been trumpeting for
such a black and white issue.
Especially with these guys,
the nation's health care.
We've used Charlie up our time. Tony May and Charlie Giroux, thank you both for being here and for all your statewide.